kind of an escape, indoor outdoor oasis. You know, you're going on a little trip. You're not even in the city anymore.
Welcome to the first fully operational cannabis restaurant in the United States. It's a 20,000 square foot former brewery in West Hollywood with a menu that includes edibles, joints, high-tech bongs, and vapes.
What our ultimate goal is to be able to pair the cannabis with the foods. Your flower host would be like a sommelier, and we want the food service to be versed in cannabis as well.
Lilia Stanislaw is Lau Cafe's general manager. She says that even before it opened, Lau received more than 800 job applications.
Everybody wants to work here, and I get it, but we wanted people who had experience and not just in smoking. That was a lot of what I got. It's like, hey, I'm an avid smoker. I have so much cannabis experience.
Yeah.
Like, but have you actually worked in a dispensary? How much knowledge do you have?
Opening a cafe that's legal, especially, is very important because it just breaks the walls down of negative stigmas that surround the subject that is cannabis.
Erica Soto, who is an industry veteran, works as a flower host at Lau Cafe, which is like a waitress for weed. When guests arrive, she walks them through their options, explains the effects of various strains, and advises them on proper dosage levels.
It's an environment that is loving and peaceful, and we all kind of see the veil drop when people get stoned, you know? And it's not a violent thing.
For now, Lau could only be located in the city of West Hollywood.
What is it about West Hollywood that is more open to something like this, you think?
They have been on the forefront of just being accepting of everything that needs to be liberated. West Hollywood is now known as the Mecca of cannabis. There are actually three surrounding dispensaries as we speak, and the further you go into West Hollywood, the more you're gonna find things just like us.
Because California requires that all cannabis products be tracked seed to sale and lab tested, Lau Cafe isn't allowed to make its own marijuana-infused foods or drinks. Everything must be prepackaged. After the rabbi at a nearby synagogue expressed concern that her congregants would be bombarded with the odor of weed, Lau installed massive air filters and machines that spray a scent-neutralizing essential oil called Cannabolish. And lighting up a tobacco cigarette is prohibited at Lau in compliance with a West Hollywood law. Lau Cafe's license is provisional for the first year, after which the council will decide whether to renew it. But in the meantime, more weed hospitality shops are coming. The city has issued licenses to 7 additional businesses, including one that will offer a virtual reality experience and another a day spa.
Being the first, we want to, of course, set the standard and sort of prove ourselves and prove to everyone else that this is something that can be done. We can just kind of spread the love through the country, then that's for sure what we want to do.